Hello and welcome. My name is Biljana, and this super demo focuses on extraction of facts and sentiment keywords from social media messages. In text analytics, concepts are sets of terms that are grouped together conceptually. For example, one concept could be the names of divisions in your company, such as operations, research and development, or marketing. Facts are matches of terms based on a particular relationship between the concepts. For example, in the sentence, Jane has a great job in marketing, you can match the terms Jane and marketing with a relationship of employee in a division. Sentiment keywords are terms which denote a positive or negative relationship, such as great job or terrible events. The question we are trying to answer is, what SAS conference presenters were most praised in social media and how? We will use data from social media messages from 4 SAS conferences. We will use this data in SAS Visual Text Analytics for 3 main tasks. The first one is extending predefined concepts. Predefined concepts are groups of rules included with Visual Text Analytics out of the box. They allow users to tap into the knowledge of the SAS linguists for identifying named and numerical entities. The second one is using automatic rule generation. Visual Text Analytics can help you create custom rules using automatic concept and fact rule generation. The third one is filtering with global rules. When you want to extract a particular match in most cases, but also have some exceptions, you can write a set of rules to cover most of the cases where you want a match, and then specify the conditions for the exceptions in a filter rule. Filter rules are global, which means that wherever they are placed in the model or hierarchy, they remove matches, so the matches are not part of the final output of the model. We will then visualize some of the extracted text in Visual Analytics. Because of time constraints, let me briefly review the steps I've done before I launch into the demo. I created a new text analytics project in Model Studio and imported the deduped English-only data. The pipeline includes data, text parsing, and concepts nodes. We need to use the predefined concepts, so we check the box for including them in the model and run the pipeline to get a baseline. One of the best practices in building a concept model is to first build a hierarchy and modify it through the exploration of the data. If you look at this hierarchy, you'll notice that there are only concepts for positive words. While I first started by looking at both positive and negative words, exploring the data showed that most of the tweets were in fact positive. Additionally, negation, such as not great, for example, was generally absent. So, I focused the model on extracting only positive sentiment. If you recall the 3 tasks you will see in the demo, the first one is extending predefined concepts, highlighted here. We are referring to them in the custom concept, custom person. The second task is automatic generation of concept rules, which you'll see in the pause adj concept, and fact rules, which you'll see in the pause person concept. The third task is removing ambiguity, which you will see in the global rule concept. Now, let's switch to the project in SAS Model Studio. I have already created a project and included predefined concepts. Next, we'll open the concepts node and explore the matches for the predefined concepts, as well as create some custom concepts. There are over 200 matches for the NLP person predefined concept. However, by definition, it does not include Twitter handles, which follow the pattern of the @ followed by letters, numbers, and underscores. To capture Twitter handles in addition to the NLP person matches, we create 2 additional custom concepts. The @ concept has only one rule capturing the @. The rules for the person handle concept can be created by highlighting terms in the document, right-click, and select to add this term to the rules. In the interest of time, I will add additional rules that I've already identified by pasting them into the window. There are 900 matches, Reviewing the first few looks exactly like we expected. Next, we'll create the custom person concept, which will take advantage of the predefined concept NLP person and enrich its matches by using the two other custom concepts we created, at symbol and person handle. In this concept, we will also add international names that were not captured as matches with the out-of-the-box rules. I found these through exploration of the data. The number of matched documents is over 1,100, which is about 1/4 of the total number of documents. In this way, we have been able to incorporate the matches from the predefined NLP person concept and add matches from our custom concepts to it. Next, we'll build custom concepts for positive sentiment. For the positive adjective concept, we'll take advantage of assisted rule creation using textual elements and the filter. Typing in a positive sentiment term such as good in the filter and then expanding that term to see all of the different terms that are stemming to it can help us evaluate whether we want all of these terms in our rule. If so, we can rely on a few system options to write the rule for us. In the interest of time, I will paste in some other rules that I have created based on my exploration. The matches look good, so we will continue building our model. Add a new concept, positive phrase, that will build on the matches from the positive adj concept. In the interest of time, I will paste some of the rules that I've already created through my exploration of the data. We'll run the node to make sure that the matches are expected. At first glance, examining the matches, they look good. However, as I continued to explore, I found several matches for the phrase best practices. That is not actually a positive phrase. It's just jargon. So we need to figure out how to remove it from our model, specifically from our concept for positive phrases. Create a new concept housing global rules. We created the new concept called global rule and added a new remove item rule that removes matches from the positive phrase concept when they are aligned with the terms best practices. You can see that there are no longer matches for the phrase best practices in this concept. However, one observation is still selected. This observation contains the text best practices, but it is not a match. The next concept we build is positive person. For building the fact rules in this concept, we'll use automatic rule generation. In the fact rule, we want to capture the relationship between persons and positive phrases. So we will use those two custom concepts to auto-generate a suggestion for the new fact rule. We first run the node to generate the fact rule. The fact rule has been placed in the sandbox. Let's click on that tab to see what it looks like. In this case, the system generated one rule. Sometimes it can generate more than one. To see the matches, let's run the sandbox. The matches look as expected, so we will now copy this rule from the sandbox into the concept editing tab. In the concept editing tab, we can get rid of the generic argument names, such as concept 1 and concept 2, and replace them with something that's more appropriate for our content. We'll run the node again to see the matches. Let's see the matches for each argument in the fact for the first observation. We can see that the Twitter handle at Dr. Josh is labeled as person, and great discussion is labeled as pause, which means positive phrase. Up until this point, we have seen how to extend predefined concepts with the NLP person and custom person concepts. We've seen automatic rule generation for concepts such as positive adjectives, as well as facts for the custom person concept. And we've also seen filtering with the global rule concept. Now let's look at some visualizations for the results from this model. We'll export this output table so that we can use it in visual analytics. We will add three objects. The first one is a tree map to display the person fact. Because most of the observations are missing, we will filter them out so that we can get a better view of the ones that are relevant. In the same way, we'll add two more objects, a word cloud for the positive phrases, and a table with the message text, the keywords matched by the model, and the message sender. We will also filter out missing documents from the word cloud. Next, we want to add some interactivity. When I click on a particular person, I want the other objects to update. And now for the insights. We can see that the one that was most frequently mentioned in a positive light was Oliver Schabenberger, the COO of SAS. This is not a surprise, since he was able to attend and present at all of the conferences that we were including in our data. Let's look at the specific positive phrases that were used to describe his speeches. Looking at the word cloud, we can see that some of the phrases that were most associated with Oliver were great start, great talk, and inspiring speech. The second most frequently mentioned person was Giles Hutchins. He was one of the presenters on the main stage for one of the conferences. Some phrases that were associated with him were inspiring speech and great time. In fact, the top five presenters were featured presenters at the conferences, so they probably had larger audiences than the breakout sessions, allowing these presenters more opportunities to be mentioned in social media messages. I hope you enjoyed this super demo that showed SAS visual text analytics in action with social media data. Thank you for watching.